Hello everybody, I'm John Brewer and this is Large Ship Combat 101. This is the last episode of this series, so we're going out with a bang. Today we'll be covering warheads, explosives, and the legendary nuke. Let's start with how explosions work in Space Engineers. An explosion has a damage potential and a maximum range. When it goes off, it casts out rays of damage. Those rays go out from the point of the explosion until they hit a block or reach their maximum range. If they encounter a deformable block, they damage it up to their damage potential. If the armor is destroyed by that damage, the ray is reduced by the appropriate amount and continues on. If the armor holds, the ray stops. If the ray encounters a component block, it destroys it and stops. Explosions generally come from one of two sources: warhead blocks or volatile items. Warheads come in two sizes, large and small. They are both terribly effective at destroying cubes of their type. First off, it's important to understand that warheads have two ways of being destroyed. If a warhead is destroyed by explosive damage, it just disappears the way a normal component block would. If the same warhead is destroyed by bullets or a collision, it detonates, doing considerable damage to every object near it. In addition to being set off by damage, warheads can be detonated on command. Each warhead has a safety switch and a manual detonation command. The detonation command can be issued either through the terminal or via a triggered action, such as from a sensor or a timing block. The detonation command will only result in an explosion if the safety is off, however. In addition, each warhead comes with a built-in timer. This timer works the same way as a timer block, but instead of triggering a number of actions at the end of the timer, the warhead explodes. The timer does not check to see if the safety is engaged. In addition to the terminal controls, a warhead has lights on the outside which indicate what mode that warhead is in. Green lights indicate the safety is engaged. Yellow lights indicate the safety has been disengaged and the warhead will respond to the detonate command. Blinking red indicates the warhead is counting down to detonation. The red lights blink faster and faster the closer the count gets to zero. Warheads aren't the only way to generate explosions in Space Engineers, though. The explosives item is a critical component of warheads in survival mode, but on its own, it is even more volatile than the warheads themselves. Explosives can be detonated by bullets or impacts just as warheads can, but they will also be detonated by nearby explosions. When a single stack of explosives detonates, its damage potential is equal to about 54% of a light armor block. Its range depends on the number of explosives in the stack. The blast radius is 1 centimeter per explosive in the stack, or 1 meter per 100 count. So detonating a stack of 500 explosives would produce a blast that will destroy components as far as 5 meters away, while a 1,000 explosive stack would destroy the first component in each direction up to 10 meters away. This blast size scales up quite far, which brings us to the variable yield explosives, usually referred to in the community as nukes. Despite the name, the explosive component of nukes are the same conventional explosives used elsewhere in Space Engineers. Before volumetric explosions were added in October of 2014, building nukes with explosives was terribly simple and effective. A stack of explosives would create a sphere of destruction around the blast point that would annihilate nearly everything in it. Now nukes require a bit more finesse to build and use properly. Essentially, a nuke is a device that coordinates the detonation of one or more stacks of explosives in a tactically useful way. A nuke transports the explosive stacks to the target, releases them into space, and then detonates them, usually by the means of a warhead block. The simplest nukes carry explosive stacks in a container block. When it is time to detonate the nuke, a piston destroys the container, releasing the stacks of explosives into space. Then, either a sensor or a timer triggers the initiator warhead and detonates the explosive stacks, creating the explosions that damage the target. Because armor blocks the rays the explosion casts, it is usually preferable to detonate the nuke some distance from the target. The exact effect of a nuke can be configured by varying the number and size of the stacks it carries. To demonstrate, let's look at the effect two different nukes can have on a Nervous Gamma frigate. The first nuke will be loaded with a single stack of 20,000 explosives. It creates one big explosion 200 meters in radius that destroys the first set of components it strikes and damages the light armor all along one side of the ship. The second nuke will be loaded with four stacks of 5,000 explosives. We can see the result is more compact, but considerably deeper, breaching all the way to the center line of the ship. By varying the number and size of the stacks in a nuke, the weapon can produce a variety of damage profiles, from stripping a target of its turrets to destroying a well-shielded reactor section with a single blow. I hope you've enjoyed Large Ship Combat 101. I'll be back with another series in 2015. Until then, thank you all for watching. I'm John Brewer. Come and learn from my mistakes.